Hey guys, so it's Matthew here with Great Outdoors and greatoutdoors.ie. Here today, just finished a nice little run here in the Dublin Mountains. It's quite a cold October morning, and I'm just going to run you through quickly how to make, I can see my breath, how to make coffee in the outdoors using your favourite coffee of choice. It's trying to stay away from those instant sachets, which can be quite good, but are a bit hit and miss. How to bring the at-home coffee experience into the great outdoors. So I've got a bag of the Bean Merchant's ground coffee here. So I'm just gonna brew up a personal favorite of mine coffee in a personal favorite of mine location, the great outdoors. So I've just boiled up my water here. You can see that's boiling away. So I'll turn that off and stop shouting. But we're just doing a single brew today, so I'm going to run you through how that's done. So this is the Stanley Pour Over unit here. It is stainless steel, dishwasher safe, amazing build quality as we've come to expect with Stanley at this stage over the past 50 years that they've been making flasks and accessories. You can see there's a filter in here. This filter is removable and replaceable, and it's dishwasher safe as I mentioned. This is wide enough to fit over their biggest, or the biggest that we sell anyway, Stanley flasks, and as I said, you can brew well more than one or two cups of coffee through this. The fact that it doesn't use disposable filter is obviously going to benefit us outdoor enthusiasts as far as not packing out things and not obviously littering and stuff like that as well. So Stanley have designed this pour over unit to work with your standard coffee grind. So I got the lads to do a medium grind, sort of a standard grind for this. So quantity wise of coffee, it's 3 tablespoons for every 1 cup of coffee that you want to make. So I'm gonna brew straight into a flask today, because I am on the move and it's quite cold. Flasks are a really good way of enjoying coffee in the outdoors as well, regardless of this system. You could definitely brew up your coffee and then go for your hike or walk, or brew up your coffee at the campsite and then have your mid-morning coffee as well. But the first stage of the brew process is letting the grounds bloom. So basically what you do is you, in a circular motion, if you can, pour about half of your water around the grounds. It allows the grounds to release their CO2 prior to adding all of the water. This will help develop a bit of a crema. You can pay as much or as little attention as you want to brewing your coffee through this pour over. It's really designed to be as easy to use as possible, so you can just dump the water in and then you can just leave it to drip through for about 4 minutes. So now the coffee has dripped the whole way through. If it does take a little bit more than 3 to 4 minutes, you can either scour the side of the filter with a spork or something like that to just clear away some of the beans that have stuck to the filter, or you can just sort of swirl it around and that'll dump the rest of the coffee into your flask. One thing to bear in mind before you enjoy your brew is always pack out your coffee grounds. They are a natural fiber, obviously, but they're not to be disposed of in the great outdoors. Definitely pack them out, bring them home, and compost them at home. So then you can remove the filter, obviously, and enjoy your lovely coffee. But yeah, I hope this was useful. If you have any questions, as I said, leave them below, or send us a message, or pop into the store on South Great Georgia Street, and we'll see you very soon for another video. I'm gonna enjoy my coffee now.